give them bread hands. Say, what's up, America? I think you should know me, right? Other half a replica. Background of your program or your game, and how to display your image on the screen. So let's get started for this video. Also, in this video I'm gonna tell you how to move your image, that is how to move that badger. Well, now I think most of you guys have got an interest in this video, so without wasting your much time, I'm gonna go on that topic instantly. So first of all, let me restart it. I'm pressing F5 to restart my program. Wait a second guys, it is starting. Oh, okay, sorry guys for inconvenience, let me start it again. Wait a second guys. Wait a second. So guys, okay, I'm again starting it. This time it should run. Okay, here it is. Well, this is the point till where we have last, we have reached in the last video. Sorry, in the previous video, sorry. So we have our colored background and we have our image, that is badger. And in this video, I'm gonna show you how we can move badger. That is how we can move this image up, down, left, right. Okay guys, so let's start. I'm gonna close it. Okay. So guys, this is our code, okay, till the previous video. So in this code, we will do some changes now. So look guys here, that is this if and after this block. Okay guys, after the sys.exit and the zero in parentheses, give it enter and again an enter and then give it space, okay, backspace, or you can also I have done it so that I can move the cursor inside the for loop, but inside the for loop only, so that our next code will also be processed in the for loop. So let's start it. I'm gonna write if event dot type double is equals to pygame dot in capital letters key down. Okay guys, and then colon. So this code of line tells Python that user is going to press a button, that is user is going to press a button on the keyboard, and after this line we have to write what will happen if user presses a specific key. So first of all, we have to define that specific key. So for that I will write this code. If in small letters, if event dot key double is equals to pygame dot then capital letters k then underscore d o w n, that is down arrow key. Okay guys, down arrow key, and then I will give it a colon. That means if the user presses a key, and then also if the user presses down arrow key, then what will happen? Then if user presses down arrow key, then Oh guys, at this point of time we must assign two new variables, that is x underscore change. I will write it in small n lower case letters only, so that they will not be a problem for me. So x underscore change. Is equals to 0, and then y underscore change is equals to 0. So we have defined our two new variables, that is x underscore change is equals to 0 and y underscore change is equals to 0. So what we are going to do now is I will go here, I will give it an enter, and I'll press enter, sorry, not give it. So now I will write x underscore change is equals to 0, then y underscore change is equals to 10. Okay guys, so let me explain you what this whole code will do. It will not do anything now because we have to write one more code, but I will give an overview to you. So here in this code I have specified that if user presses a key, okay, if the user presses a key, then what will, and then also I have specified that if user press a down arrow key, okay guys, this line says Python, if the user presses a down arrow key, then what will happen, x underscore change this variable and y underscore change this variable, the value of x underscore change will be 0 and the value of y underscore change will be 10, positive 10. Okay guys, so what this will do is it will help us to move our badger from its initial point position to another position. I will show you how. Okay guys, but for that let me write another code, and this code must be outside for loop but inside while loop. Okay guys, so I'm gonna write it here. So I will write y is equals to y plus y underscore change. So we have write it here. So y is equals to y underscore plus y is equals to y plus underscore. Okay, sorry guys, I'm messing up. Okay, y is equals to y plus y underscore change. Okay, what will it do is, look guys, our y coordinate is 634, and this y coordinate is of badger's top left, badger's images top left corners coordinate. Okay guys, so this 634, this variable will be y, that is 634 plus y underscore change. That means if user will press down arrow key, then what will happen, positive 10 will be added to this number 634, so that the badger will move downwards. Okay guys, so this is the logic behind it. So I'm gonna write some more codes, and after that I will show you how it is done. So this much is right. So now I'm gonna write if event dot key is equals to double is equals to pygame dot key underscore up. Okay guys, that means this code says Python that if the user presses up arrow key, okay guys, that is forward arrow key, then what will happen, then the x underscore change is equals to 0, y underscore change is equals to minus 10. Okay guys, so why did I write minus 10, so that the badger's image will go towards the top of the our window. Okay guys, because the top left corner of our window is 00. That means if the badger's image is going top, that means we have to subtract this something from the y coordinate of badger's image. So let's run it now. Okay guys, so I'm pressing F5. I'm pressing F5 to okay. So it must run. Okay, so here is our window. So let's see on pressing key it moves or not. So here it is. Here is our badger is moving, right? But the thing is that if I press arrow key up, then the badger will go only up. It will not stop. But we want the badger to stop when we are not pressing key up key that. Okay, guys. And if we press down key, then it will start moving downwards, but it will not stop. So for that, we have to write some more codes. Okay, guys. So to do that, I'm gonna close this window. So let's do it. So as I have written this code for the key down, that means if the user presses a key, that means the if the user presses a key downwards, then this much will happen. So same as it is, I will write a code for if the key is up, that means no one has pressed key, or if after pressing key the key comes upward, right? So at that situation what will happen. So I'm gonna write that code now. So let's write it. If event dot type double is equals to pygame dot key up. Okay, oh sorry guys, it must be in block letters. Key up and then colon. So if this is the case, then what will happen? So if event dot key double is equals to pygame dot key in the block letters k underscore down, then y underscore change, it equals to 0 again, and x underscore change is always 0. And now I will write this code for up arrow key. Okay guys, so if event dot key double is equals to pygame dot block letters k underscore up, then what will happen is y underscore ch a n g e change is equals to 0, and x underscore change is also is equal to 0. So let me explain you what will this code do. So the thing is that if after pressing a key the arrow key comes upward, right, it is a rebound. So at that position the y underscore change, this variable will be 0, and hence since this is our code that y is equals to y plus y underscore change, then after moving 10 pixel backward or forward, this y underscore change will be 0, and then y is equals to y. That means the next position will become the initial position of the badger. Alright guys, so let me explain, let me show you it in more detail by saving it and running it. So let's see our code works or not. Okay guys, this time it is good, right? What happened? Wait a minute guys. Oh sorry guys, it must be in block letters. Something is okay. Yes, this up must be written in uppercase letters. Now let's again save it and run it. So let's see this time it works or not. Okay, after pressing one key it moves 10 pixel backward after pressing up key, okay, up arrow key, and after pressing down key, down arrow key, it moves 10 pixels downward. So hence our code is working. Look guys, our code is working, but the problem wait a second guys, if I press it here also, then this badger's image goes beyond the screen. It is there, but the thing is that it will go on a virtual world, right? And the virtual world is limitless. It will go at the infinity, but we don't want it. We want that if it goes here, the game must crash, right? So to do that, we have to do some more work. Well, but till now we have our badger moving, and this is really, 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 really cool. So I think for this video it is enough. And if you have any suggestions or if you have any questions, then you can post them in the comment box. And you can also connect with me on the Twitter or Facebook. And if you want to download this picture or and the soundtrack that I will use in this game, then you can download them by the link I have given in the description of this video. So stay tuned till then, and goodbye.